All right, guys, and that's gonna do it for part one of cutting this stump. This is definitely one of those projects that I knew was going to test me mentally and physically, and it just so happens that was the case. It's starting to get dark out, bugs are starting to come out, but I'll show you the progress that I've made. I was able to take off quite a bit of the bark. It is relatively thick, and in some places it's hard to get off, so I'm hoping once it's sort of exposed to some rain and maybe a few dry days, maybe it will start to peel off itself. But I'm not too worried about this. I think that's the least of my concerns, so I'll just work on that as I go. You can see I got a good chunk of it off right there, so I think that'll go relatively easy. Once I do get all of the bark off, I do plan to sand it a little bit to make it look nice. But this is the part that is going to take a monumental amount of effort. You saw me drill all of the holes. The drill was getting so hot that I had to stop several times in order to let it cool down. And this wood is definitely some sort of hardwood. It smelled like cherry. It smelled like cherry was burning as I was drilling the holes. So I don't know exactly what it is. Some people in the last video said it might be ash, might be maple. I don't know. But it's certainly a hard wood. And this is what I was able to accomplish here. You'll see this central hole was already there. And the holes I was able to drill around it, I think will enable me to at least get a good start. You saw I used the chisel to sort of pop a few of these pieces out, and hopefully just the start of this is the hardest part. But as you see here, if I zoom out, we're gonna need to drill a lot more holes and do a lot more chiseling in order to carve this out, because I want to get up to like an inch away from the entire edge here of this stump, and then I want to go down a good 12 inches into that log. So that is a lot of material to remove. So hopefully the drill will last. Hopefully it won't catch on fire and explode. I'll just take it slow and see what I can do. I'm not convinced that chiseling is the best way to get these pieces of wood out. And what I might do is I might put my drill holes a little bit closer together in order to make it easier to pop more of those pieces of wood out. But if you guys have any suggestions on how you think I could do this a little bit faster, let me know. A couple things I don't want to do. I do not want to use a chainsaw and plunge cuts. That would probably be the fastest thing. And the reason being, I don't want any of the chain oil getting into the wood, because obviously this is going in a turtle tank. The other thing that I don't really want to do is start a fire in the middle of it and try to burn out the middle, because then I don't have any control over how far away that fire is from the wall of that wood. And I think what will happen is it'll just burn out one side quicker than it burns out another side, and it's going to leave an irregular shaped charred hole in the middle, and that just sounds like a giant mess. And again, I don't want that in the tank either. But if you have any ideas, let me know. I'm definitely open to suggestions. This looks like it's going to be a lot of work, but at least I've gotten started. At least I've learned a little bit about the process, and we'll see if we can improve together. So let me know what you think. This is going to be a multi-part video for sure, and this is just the start. So we'll see where it goes from here. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys later.